So we broadly have four implementation models that we recommend. And all of these are a function of what you are using Khan Academy for and where are you using it as well. Whether you're using it as a learning tool or whether you're using it as a strengthening tool, where you're trying to reinforce topics that have, you know, students have previously have knowledge of, or this is something that is entirely new for them and you're helping them to acquire a new concept or to learn a new concept, and where this is happening, whether it's happening inside the classroom or whether it's happening outside the classroom. So just at the intersection of, you know, these four things, we have four models. I'll talk about the first one. The first one is where it's part of the classroom lecture. And this is the one where it is very tightly integrated into your classroom learning. So for example, I am teaching rational numbers today. How I would teach rational numbers is that as a teacher, I would first kind of, you know, in that class itself, teach a little bit about it, use the videos from Khan Academy maybe to do the teaching, use the content and the exercises and the quizzes to make students practice in it. So this is where you're really interspersing it with your learning and you're using it to introduce a new concept to the students. The second thing is in-class practice, where you're effectively, you're not using the videos, and you're basically relying only on the exercises and the quizzes and the unit tests for the students to be able to practice and really reinforce what you as a teacher have already specifically taught them. So these are the two in-classroom models that we talk about. The other two out-of-classroom models that we talk about are one, a flipped classroom. Now, this is something that's very interesting and a few schools are starting to do this. Teachers give this content as homework to the students before. And before they've introduced a new topic in class, students really kind of watch that video maybe and come to the class so that they have some pre-knowledge about that topic. And then in the class, you teach it as a teacher as you normally would have. But through this model, you're able to kind of ensure that students are already coming in with some knowledge, some baseline already. So that kind of for them. And the last model is as homework, where students are able to do it at home, because, you know, in school you may not have the devices, you may not be able to find time on the timetable to be able to do this, or the teachers are using it as content for themselves, not for the students, because they do not think it is appropriate enough for the students, or students may not be able to solve this currently. However, the teacher believes that, you know, like, they want to learn how to teach something in a different way. They want to, like, learn a new concept. They want to revise a topic that, you know, that they might not remember entirely. So a lot of teachers just use our content to brush up on their learning. So before you have a topic that you're going to be teaching in class, you go through the videos on Khan Academy. So this is a new way to really teach this topic. So there's a lot of our teachers who are able to use Khan Academy just for themselves. In fact, we've not done this in India yet, but in Brazil, there was a summer program that was organized by the government over there, where all of the teachers were expected to complete all of the content for whichever grade levels that they teach on Khan Academy. So in this summer, just so that they were able to revise that institute for the year, they went through all of our videos, all of our practice content, just to really brush up on their own concepts and also, you know, just understand, you know, just regain some of that conceptual understanding so that they are able to teach it to their students as well. So broadly, these are the implementation models that we've seen, you know, and we've heard like feedback from teachers from across these implementation models, where they feel that the content's been helpful to them. They believe that their students' attention becomes more focused and optimum. I think one thing that we consistently hear is that Khan Academy removes the fear of math in students, because it really allows you to go at your own pace. There's no pressure to keep up with the classroom, really. One thing that we heard from teachers that we're now working on is we're trying to map the difficulty level of the question according to the student's learning level. So if the learning level is lower, we're making sure that they're initially getting easier questions and then progressing to difficult questions. Now, this is something that we've been working on here as well. And yeah, everyone thinks that it's a very fun thing and keeps their classroom very engaged and excited through whatever that one or two classes or whether it's being given as homework as well. I just want to very quickly talk about the common traits that we've seen in some of the projects which work really well wherever teachers and students are using it. One thing is that, and you know, if there are any principals on this conversation, on this webinar as well, it's very important that, you know, your principal and your school management supports you and all of the teachers who are participating in this. And even if the teachers are discussing it amongst themselves, that really makes the whole project very successful. Infrastructure becomes critical now, whether that's a basic smartphone or basic tablet, maybe you have a computer lab in your school where students can kind of go and you know, use Khan Academy. It's important to have this because unfortunately at the end of the day we are a tech company, and we're trying to, you know, work around what are some of the other ways that we can make this more and more accessible. But for now, we need some kind of technologies. Another thing is that as a teacher, and I'm sure that even after this webinar, there was a lot of information that was given. And, you know, this might seem like a lot of content. However, it's a very simple platform. So all you need to do is just spend some time getting used to it. Maybe you've used technology in the classroom before. Maybe this is the first time for you. But in any case, if you just spend like a month or two getting used to the platform, you will master it entirely. I have seen, you know, 60-year-old teachers in really rural parts of Rajasthan who've never even seen a smartphone kind of get used to this. So I'm very confident that folks who can navigate a very complicated Zoom will be able to ace this platform as well. So, you know, looking, and you know, it's all a question of just believing that this is something new that you want to try, and I'm sure you will all be able to do it. If you're planning to use this in school, it's helpful to have a dedicated slot on the timetable where you're able to use Khan Academy, because otherwise if it's not on the timetable, it really never ends up happening. And, you know, just to make sure that we're seeing regular usage and to make sure Khan Academy is effective, we suggest that you put it in your timetable, whether it's once a week, whether it's twice a week, or whether it's once in 2 weeks, based on whatever your constraints are. We've seen this to be very helpful. One very, very important thing, and my last two points tie into each other, is that it's very important to integrate Khan Academy content with your lesson plan, and I'll show you a sample lesson plan, because only when you are selecting the right content and making sure that it is relevant for the students will they be able to kind of will we be able to get the outcomes, the learning outcomes that we desire. I think all we're looking for is to improve our student learning levels. That's why we're all over here. And for that, just making sure that whatever content it is that we're using is very, very suitable and very relevant, that becomes important. So just very quickly, I want to show you like a sample session plan that was created where, you know, like it's really kind of broken down by the week, where you can see Monday and Tuesday, they kind of spend some time talking about something, some topics in algebra. And Wednesday, when they have their Khan session, they've actually selected which are the videos or the assignments that they're going to be giving to the students, or what will they be using in class. This makes sure that your entire process is very, very cohesive. And they've integrated it with their lectures and worksheets that you can see as well. So there'll be some content that you want to cover from the textbook, there'll be some content you want to cover from Khan Academy. So like it becomes very helpful to have this in place.